Live from Studio 5 in New York City, this is the News at 6.
So I can talk to my guest today. Oh, Dr. Michael Woodward is joining us. Hello.
Oh, boy. Good to see you, Dr. Woodward.
I'm breathing, too.
You are breathing well, and it's all coming back, right? It makes you feel good. I'm so happy you're here today, because you know what? This is all about helping people get through all of these difficulties, and it can be done. It could be a personal problem. It could be professional. Mm-hmm. I saw that the number one fear is public speaking. Tell me about that.
Yeah, according to the National Institute for Mental Health, 74% of Americans have some sort of fear of public speaking. And now think of it this way. It's not just standing up in front of an audience. It could be going to that job interview. It could be presenting in front of a boss or even standing up at that PTA meeting, because at the end of the day, you're putting yourself out there and you're standing up in front of folks or putting yourself in a way that you're not sure what's going to happen.
So what do we do?
So that makes you, it makes you nervous.
Yeah.
So it's a couple things. First, you know, there is that fear of the unknown, like I mentioned. And what you need to do is step back and take control of that by creating a kind of a plan. So sketch out how something's going to happen. So if you're going to that job interview, where am I going to go? What's the route I'm going to take to get there? What does it look like sitting down and asking the questions and answering those questions? And what are the kind of things that I can do to prepare myself to be confident
and ready? So it's having a plan. I like that.
Does that
also apply if someone has, whether it's a fear of flying or aging or retirement or whatever it happens to be? Do you use the same idea?
Well, think of it this way. Professional athletes and coaches like to vision right before they do something. They like to see how it's going to play out.
Right.
And what's important is you've got a vision for success. You've got to see yourself acing the job interview. You've got to see yourself successfully getting on that plane. You've got to see yourself winning at whatever it is, because then you start to build that confidence internally, but you see the positive outcome. And then you got to back it up and start sketching out how those little wins look along the way.
So it's control and it's having confidence is what you're saying, right?
Yeah. The big issue, and I think that underlies most any anxiety, is that perceived lack of control, that fear of the unknown.
That's true.
And the way you create certainty is by proactively stepping back and thinking about, what's the certainty I want to create and see for myself? What are the steps and things I got to do? Sketch it out, draw it out, have a roadmap. You can't get to a destination if you don't have a roadmap.
Right. Good reading, good exercise, I'm sure, is part of that.
Sure.
Bottom line, if we really want to think about our fear and overcoming that, what should we be thinking about?
First of all, you need to be positive. You've got to get rid of the negative self-talk, because we all fall back into that worry, and it snowballs the anxiety on itself. So step back and start thinking about, what's the positive outcome? Think about how to be confident. Prepare. Read what you need to read. Do your homework. Build the confidence, practice with friends, and get that support you need.
And I've heard people say the victory feels great. Once you've overcome something, it's just the strongest feeling that you can have about yourself and about the future.
And it's the small victories.
Yeah.
Make sure to celebrate the small successes along the way, because they build on themselves.
Great. Dr. Woody, always a pleasure to have you. Thank you so much for joining us. We feel good.
I hope so.
Okay.
That's the idea.
Thank you. All right.